like that. But I don't, so thank God. So like I just had a baby like a month ago for reals. Crazy? Oh my God, I love it. People are so fucking nice to you when they find out you have a baby. Fuck! I didn't know that! God damn it! If I knew people were gonna be this nice to me, I would have gotten knocked up when I was 11. Okay? But how we got through all the awkward here, do you know? I was never good at that. You guys, here's the deal about children, okay? Let's just cut to the dick, okay? Children are growing up so fast these days. I just spit on your face. I'm so sorry. Okay. You know, I was always something epic happens when I go to fucking Denny's bathroom. Okay. Like I was in a Denny's bathroom and I walk in. Okay. And you go to the handicap stall because you always need a lot of room, right? Don't we need room to fucking piss? If you think you're pissing, okay. I thought I was pissing. I thought it was a piss, you guys, okay? But I take so much of that fucking smooth move. You know that shit? That shit's the bomb, okay? Literally. So I don't sit on toilets because I don't want to get diseases, remember? Okay? So I was in the bathroom, like at the Denny, and because you can't sit on the toilet because the thing and that every time you put those things and they fall in the fucking toilet, you know what I mean? You're just like putting this fucking into the toilet and if the fucking things on the goddamn motherfucking the thing is all fucking all the way up there. It's like, ah! You know? Finally it stays in there because there's piss on the toilet, okay? So it sticks, all right? So you just do one of these things. It's a yoga move. You know? And so I was doing that, but it's pointless because basically you just urinate down your leg, right? And it just follows along the floor, you know what I mean? But it was one of those epic days, and suddenly you guys, and don't think I'm gross, but I pooped right then and there, and you guys, I'm sorry, it was disturbing because it's a very difficult position to poop in this position, okay? And I'm not a poopy comic, don't take this the wrong way, but it happened so fast. You know, you didn't plan for it, you know what I mean? Like, you're like, what the fuck? I was just planning on pissing in here, you know what I mean? And then it's like, it just was going fast, okay, you know what I mean? But it was all that fluffed up from the fucking papers, right? Like, move a little, you know what I mean? Because it scared me, you know what I mean? Because I always think, like, outhouses and a hand comes up and grabs your fucking vagina, you know? But it didn't, you know, I saw Jaws too early in life, you know what I mean? So then it got a little bit on the floor, and don't freak out, you guys, but I was trying to wipe up the urine, and then the little poop was there, so I just kind of like went like that. But then I was like, you know what I mean? Because there's no toilet paper, and I started going like that. I'm like, oh my God, I'm a smearer. I'm a fucking smearer, you know what I mean? And those people in the bathrooms on the road, I'm Route 66 in the bathroom, the smearer. And then I was like, fuck it, let's just get into it. Smear angel, you know what I mean? Then I was like, that was kind of fun. So then people came in the bathroom, like, fuck, it's only one stall. You can't like duck under, you know what I mean? So I was like, fuck. So I was like, what the fuck am I gonna do? So I just instead I just like kick it up. I'm like, fucking animals in there! Fucking animals in there! Fucking trying to go in there with them goes! Right, anyway, so I had a baby, and that's what we do, and it's great when you have a baby, because they're so cute, and I've already lost 32 pounds, isn't that great? Thank you. Cocaine! I'm just kidding, no. Actually, we're nursing, you know, like, in fact, that's all I do all day long, I just nurse, 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 I don't get out much. So I have to do all my shopping online. Like, I got this app on this website called CougarFuneral.com. So great. And then there's another pop-up store that came up where I have this, Forever 43. Evil, fucking evil. Anyway, so I live in downtown Los Angeles. Should I work on that? It's a really nice neighborhood. You do? Oh, that's great. I live on the corner of 9th and Crack Pipe. It's a great place to raise a baby. But so so when I'm out strolling with my little girl, I've gotten just a little bit overprotective, you know what I mean? Because there's weird people out there, you know. And I'm scared of myself. No. So I was strolling with the baby, and then I noticed there was a girl behind me, and she's wearing a beret, you guys. If you're in a beret with buttons on it, you're not fucking fighting for our country. You're a dangerous line. You're a fucking dangerous line. You know what I mean? Or you're French, which is worse, okay? So I started walking, a little bit faster, and then I noticed that she started walking a little bit faster. So then I started cantering, So then I started walking a little bit faster, then she was clearly following me and walking faster. So I turned the corner, then she turned the corner, and I turned around, stop! You know what I mean? And she's like, And I was like, okay, you know what? I have a newborn baby, and you're in my personal space, okay? So can you please just back away a little bit? She's like, but man, I need to ask you about you. You know, and I was like, seriously, can you please just back away? I have a baby here, and she's like, but man, I'm like, listen, you have things on your face and things in your teeth, okay? They look very germy, okay? And they're permeating germs near my baby, so can you please just back away from me? She's like, but man, I'm like, I didn't do that part. And she was like, ma'am, I just want to know if I'm going to go hey, ma'am, do you have pimples? Okay. I'm an adolescent. And you're a cruel, cruel woman. Does that get too dark? Do you think at the end of it? Should I take it back a little? Alright. Being a kid in the 80s was very tough, you know? Because they had no good hair products for curly hair, okay? So every time I tried to feather my hair, I ended up looking like Pat Benatar with a wallet, okay? Love the battlefield. Okay, fuck you guys, but you're all 22 years old. You're Pat Benatar. So, does a smear joke work? Okay, because that's new. Okay. What did I want to say? Oh yeah, you guys, I'm really annoyed about the cell phone laws. I just feel like Jesus Christ. First it started off where you can't talk on the phone, without an earpiece. Okay, fine. Okay, and then it was no texting in the car. Because some fucking asshole was texting and drive and drove off a fucking cliff and ruined the fun for everyone. Okay. So, when I'm out driving, I always feel like I'm always freaked out that there's a cop seeing me, right? You know what I mean? You're like, ugh, you know what I mean? And but instead, what's worse is there are citizens out there that love to take the law into their own hands. They're these cell phone vigilantes, they get so freaked, you're like this, and they're like, stop, you're like, whoa, okay, I was fucking masturbating, okay? Can you relax, So, the other day, I was on the phone. And I was on the highway and I was driving, and I was like, oh my god, Sharon, we should totally do the master cleanse. We did it 3 years ago, remember? We hated each other because you go crazy on the master cleanse.
I haven't eaten in 19 days. Except for cayenne pepper and lemonade. I love Los Angeles.
It was a bad time. Oh, sorry. Anyway, So yeah, maybe we should do that. Anyway, and then and I look over and suddenly there's like someone in the other car, and he's like, roll down the window. Roll down the window. Roll it down. I'm like, oh my god, weird. There's some guy like yelling at me. He doesn't have automatic windows. I don't know what he wants. Like, what is he saying? You know, he's like, get off the fucking phone or you're gonna kill somebody. You hear me? You're gonna fucking kill somebody on that cell phone. And I'm like, I don't understand what he's saying. He's like, get off the fucking phone. Get off the fucking. And I'm like, oh my god, that's so horrible. The guy just smashed a pole. Oh, he was trying to tell us to get off the phone. He knew we're Skyping. I just do that. Did that work? No? Okay, so. So what did I want to leave you with? This. I'll leave you with this. Okay, so the downtown is weird, but there are really, my neighbors are great. They're very supportive of my career. And they're wonderful. Like, my neighbor Maria is fantastic. I was walking inside the building today. And there she was. She doesn't actually live in the building. She lives against the building. But she's a great lady. You know what I mean? And so I was walking out, and she looked up to me. You know what I mean? And, you know, obviously I'm crystal meth. Okay. And, you know what I mean? Because, you know, like, people are crystal meth, their faces sort of, well, they're like pinball machines. You know, you know? So she looked up at me. She's like, Mira. I'm like, you know who you look like today? And I was like, someone with a Bachelor of Finance degree in Academia Laude. She's like, no, more like a bloated version of Katy Perry. You kiss the girl, you like it. And I was like, you kissed your blind to this chihuahua and he liked it. The joke doesn't work, you just keep on doing that. And then people just get on board with you on that. Okay, you guys. I'm gonna leave it. You guys are great. Thanks so much for coming.